Good morning, 8th class students. Welcome to NS class. In previous class, second lesson NS subject, I completed second lesson cell, the basic unit of life. Okay, children. Today, all of you open page number 22. There you can find out a box, you have to fill it. All of you open page number 22. Observe the table, take one sharpened pencil, fill the box with the sharpened pencil neatly. This helpful to shows us about different cells have different shapes and perform different functions. Okay, first column, if you will observe this, we can find out four columns: serial number, name of the cell, shape of the cell, name the parts, observe it. First one is RBC, already they gave, no? There you can write down. The shape of RBC are circular or biconcave. Write down there. Circular or biconcave. Name the parts in it. Write down. Cell membrane and cytoplasm. They does not have nucleus, no? Nucleus. So write down. Second one, muscle cell, spindle shape. Muscle cell, spindle shape, parts in it means cell membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. Write down there. Okay, muscle cell. Next one is nerve cell. How the nerve cell will be? Tree with the branches. Parts, you have to write three parts, enough. Many will be, but no need to learn about this. We have to write three parts, that is enough. Cell body, axon, dendrites. Three parts enough. Next one is bone cell. How will be? Star shape. Star shape. Parts means, write down. Cell body. Cytoplasm. Nucleus. Cell membrane. Last cell, WBC, white blood cell. Write on there, no shape. That does not have particular shape. Write down, same, cytoplasm, nucleus, cell membrane. So here they give five cells to you children: RBC, muscle cells, nerve cells, bone cells, white blood cells. If you observe here, RBC, red blood cells, circular and biconcave in shape. Now, muscle cell, spindle shape, already I explained in previous class. Nerve cell, tree with branches. Star cell, bone cell, star shape. White blood cells does not have particular shape and parts in it. So, based on this, we concluded that different cells have different shapes and perform different functions. See here, all these are different cells, like red blood cells, muscle cell, nerve cell, bone cell, white blood cells. They have different shape, like biconcave or circular shape, spindle shape, tree with branches shape, star shape, nose shape. Functions also, we can find different functions. See here, red blood cells helpful to carry oxygen and CO2. Muscle cells helpful for movement of body parts, whether it is internal or external. Nerve cells helpful to carry messages from sense organ to brain or spinal cord, from spinal cord brain up to sense organs. Bone cells present in bones, which will give a framework to the body. White blood cells does not have particular shape, particular shape which helpful to kill harmful germs when entered our body. Based on this, we concluded that different cells have different shape and perform different functions. Next, open page number 23. There you can find out a box. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Meter is the largest measurement. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 nanometers. 1 micrometers, 1 micrometer, 1000 nanometers. Do you know nanometer is the simplest unit, measurement unit? Okay. Meter, centimeter, millimeter, micrometer, nanometer. So microorganisms will be measured in by nanometers. They can be seen only with the help of microscope, children. Now I will explain about keywords which are present in lesson 2. With the help of keywords, you can understand, you can revise the total lesson cell, the basic unit of life once again. First keyword is cell. Already I explained, cell observed by Robert Hooke. Cell can be seen with the help of microscope. Some people thought big onions have big cells, small onions have small cells. Correct or not? But that is not correct. Whether it is big on or small, onions are made up of cells. Cells can be seen only with the help of microscope. They may be millionth of a meter. Of a meter lo million and month lo unta the cell. Whether it is big onion or small onion, whether it is elephant or amoeba, whether it is elephant or man, whatever it may be, cell can be observed with the help of microscope. Why? But why they have small, big onions have big in size, small in size means according to the number of cells. So the size of organism determine the number of cells but not cell size. So big onion or small onion have same sized cells, but number of cells will be different compared than big onion to small onion. Next one is cell membrane. Cell membrane. So if you will observe in cell, we can find out center portion of cell is called nucleus, and the cover called cell membrane, and the jelly like substance called cytoplasm. So this is a cell membrane. Cell membrane also called as plasma membrane, children. Third one is cell wall. Cell wall will only present in a plant cell, absent in the animal cell. Already I explained about nucleus, onion pea. There you can find out cell wall. This cell wall only present in plant cell, absent in the animal cell. This cell wall will give protection, extra support to the plants. If cell wall is absent, plant cannot stand straight or erect. Cell wall will give external support to the plant when you pour water. Next keyword is cytoplasm. If you will observe in cell, the jelly-like substance known as cytoplasm, there you can find out cell organelles. Cell organelles means parts of cell. Cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance which present inside of the cell. There you can find out different cell organelles. Fifth one is nucleus. The center portion of cell have nucleus. Nucleus called as cell control room. All activities in the cell was controlled by nucleus, discovered by Robert Brown. Next one is unicellular organisms. Our next one is multicellular organisms. What are unicellular organisms? The organisms which are made up of only one cell is known as unicellular organisms. Like example, amoeba. They have only one cell. They have simple body structure. All activities within the cell controlled by one cell. In multicellular organisms, we can find out different cells. So, different cells perform different function. Example, man. So, that is the major difference between unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms have simple body structure. Multicellular organisms have complex body structure. One cell can perform all functions. Many cells can perform many functions. Example, amoeba. Example, man. Next one is organelles. Cell organelles. So, if you will observe in the cytoplasm of the cell, we can find out different parts. We have different parts in our body like that. Cells also have different parts. So, cell can be observed with the help of compound microscope. Nucleus can be observed with the help of compound microscope. If you want to observe the parts in it, you have to use the electron microscope. So, they are very smallest structures. That's why they can be observed with the help of electron microscope. Cell can be observed with the help of normal or compound microscope. Cell organ, different cell organs. You have to learn cell consists of nucleus and other cell organelles in cytoplasm covered by cell membrane. That is enough. If you want to learn about cell organelles, you have to learn in 9th class. So, first you have to observe in 8th class, cell have a membrane and some cells have nucleus and cytoplasm, jelly-like substance. There you can find out cell organelles. Up to here you learn. That is enough. No need to learn further. Next one is pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. This pseudopodia present in the amoeba. Do you know? Pseudo means false. Podia means field. Present in amoeba. This pseudopodia helpful for locomotion. Locomotion means movement. Why they are called false feet? Why pseudopodia called as false feet? False feet, that is pseudo means false, podia means feet. They have false feet at the time of locomotion, at the time of movement. Finger-like projections will be appear. After completion of movement, the finger-like projections will be disappear. That's why they called as pseudopodia. They called as pseudopodia. So, why they are called false feet? At the time of movement or locomotion, these finger-like projections appear. See here, if you will observe amoeba, these are known as finger-like projections, pseudopodia. At the time of movement, finger-like projections appear. After completion of movement, the finger-like projections may disappear. That's why they called as pseudopodia, false feet present in amoeba. Staining. 10th keyword, staining. So, name the staining means which help coloring. So, dyes. So, dyes means coloring. We'll use red ink naturally and saffron. These are the two things which will give color to the cells. While observing cells under microscope, staining technique will be used. This is helpful to see the object cells very clearly. Children, if you want to, while observing cells, we will use glycerin. Glycerin helpful to prevent drying the material. And this staining, these dyes or colors helpful to see the objects or cells, cells very clearly. Generally, we will use red ink or saffron to observe cells under microscope. And also, I explain how to prepare slides in school lab, no? Already we learned how to observe onion peel cells, how to observe mastic cells, how to observe cheek cells. We use some red ink, sometimes we use red ink, saffron or methylene blue, etc. We used. This is helpful to see the cells very clearly. Magnification. 11th one is magnification means increase the size. If you want to observe the cells largely, we will use microscope. This is called magnification. Magnification means increase the size of the cell. This is helpful to observe very clearly. We will use microscope to observe cells. That is called magnification. If you want to observe cells, we will use compound microscope. If you want to observe the parts in it, you have to use electron microscope. Magnification means increase the size. Normal microscope magnify the things 1000 times. Electron microscope magnify the things up to 10,000 times. Last one is keyword focusing. This word is using microscope. Focusing means seeing the object clearly, cells clear. That is called focusing. So, all these are the keywords which present in lesson 2 cell, the basic unit of life, children. Okay, up to here we completed second lesson also. In the next class, I will start third lesson, that is story of microorganism. In that you can find out part 1, part 2, you have to learn properly. Okay? Thank you, children.